I would like to introduce the curator of this show. Now, InFocus has been around for 6 years. This started, I don't know, the discussions for this show started 7 years ago, I'm pretty sure around our coffee table. And Alexis Marie, the curator of the show, she came up with this amazing idea. There's so many wonderful artists, and we want to be able to promote them. And it's a big step to move from artist to promoter to champion of all of the work that is here tonight. And this is really because of Alexis Marie. She loves the work. It's a great night that when we get to sit down and pick the work for this show, and it's definitely a fun time. So Alexis, we really appreciate you being here to talk about this, and let's see what she has to say. Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here, as Aaron said. There are a lot of familiar faces here, so probably many of you know the mission of InFocus. It is to promote, exhibit, and celebrate innovative, thoughtful, and provocative photography created by Canadian contemporary image makers. This is our sixth photography exhibit, which just to me seems like, it seems like we've been doing this longer and also not as long. A few years ago, I'm gonna be open and vulnerable tonight. So a few years ago, I had a photographer sort of critique the show and say that, oh, it would be way better if it was juried. And so what a juried show looks like is that people come from different, maybe it's different photographers or professionals, and they, as a group, review the photography and the submission package and agree on who's going to be in the show. I love juried shows, they're great. However, I'm a curator, and curation is a career, and it's also a calling. So the difference which, when you have a curator oversee a show, there's a background, a history, an education in art history. The curator looks at the exhibit in a more broad context. They spend time writing about the work and considering it critically. They are cognizant creators of culture, and it is an ongoing process. Some of the photographers with InFocus have been exhibiting with us since the beginning. And as a curator, I'm honored to watch their work evolve, watch the way they present their work change over time, and also see and help them, guide them through portfolio reviews and help promote their work through exhibitions. This is the magic of the curatorial relationship. It is an ongoing, invested, and passionate relationship between artist and curator. And I have to say that many of the photographers that I've exhibited with, I now call friends. They probably don't want to be my friend because they realize that I'm a giant goofball in real life, but it's a really special bond, and I'm really honored to be in this position. One curator I admire is Elizabeth Sussman of the Whitney Museum of American Art in New York. I'm just going to tell you a little bit of a story about her. She curated the 1999 biennial for the Whitney. And it was met with terrible reviews. One reviewer wrote for the New York Times, "This exhibition had nothing to do with art. What redeems the Whitney is that the staff member returned my money without protest." Another critic at the biennial said, "The show was less about the art of our times and more about the times themselves." Sussman said she made not one, but two calls to her therapist before she could even get out of bed the next morning. I think I would probably take that criticism pretty hard as well. It was the show that everyone loved to hate. A show she had put her heart and soul into curating was being roasted by reviewers and art critics. From my reading, Sussman sounds like a tough cookie. She kept working, kept creating exhibitions, exhibiting artists. Life didn't stop there. She moved around to different art institutions over the years that followed. For example, the Art Institute of Boston, the San Francisco Museum of Modern Art, the Getty Research Institution, and she ended up landing back at the Whitney, where she was asked, shockingly, to curate the 2012 biennial. So can you imagine being asked to curate another biennial after your first one was like such a dismal failure? I probably would have run the other direction. The 1993 biennial was about diversity, identity, self, and community. And it was met with huge backlash. Yet, almost 20 years later, she was asked to curate again because those very topics were pivotal issues in the national conversation at that time. the issues of race, gender, and sexuality and discrimination in 1993, in that biennial, were suddenly now out in the open. The artists who had been dismissed in the 1993 biennial had, in the following two decades, risen to prominence. The show that had been called a failure was now championed as a success. In Focus 2020, our theme this year is change. In this show, you will see images about gender, identity, race, the changes in our ways of life, environmental concerns, and the subtle political conversation around all of these topics. It is a show with dichotomies. Many of the images are documentary images, yet are presented in an artistic context. They are a mashup of humanitarian concerns with aesthetic considerations. This was the theme of the photography in the 80s and the 90s. It was an era where photographers were prolifically taking photographs of war, of famine. And in that time, a lot of people had not seen those images. And it did promote governments to take action. It promoted awareness. But then something resulted. It's called famine fatigue. And people saw those images so much. It's kind of like our kids watching or playing video games. Right? I don't even know what, Fortnite. My daughter wants to play Fortnite. No. But it's like they see the same thing. They see fighting and whatever over and over again. So photographers in this era, the 80s and 90s, were really looking for different ways to show their work. And so they took documentary images and recontextualized them into galleries and art books. And so that's something that we can see, the evolution of that development of photography here in this exhibition. InFocus 2020 also harkens to another photographic shift similarly pioneered in the last 20 years of the 20th century, the idea of public intimacy. It's another dichotomy, public intimacy. In this movement, photographers capitalize on the camera's ability to shed light on private moments, exposing taboo subjects. Private moments of home life, for example. You can think of Sally Mann. Does anybody know that famous photographer, Sally Mann? Yep. If you don't know Sally Mann, you should look her up. She's really cool. So these two movements, documentary art and public intimacy, are cornerstones in the work exhibited here at InFocus 2020. They are pivotal to our photographers' ideas of change. Change. I don't think any of us would argue that we are in a season of intense transition. The environment is top of mind, reflected in Greta Thunberg's selection as Time's Person of the Year in 2019, whether you love her or hate her. Politically, Alberta, Canada, we're in the throngs of new governments and new policy, not to mention our friends south of the border with the US's continuing Trump saga. The average person is more vocal today about change than ever before, thanks in good part to social media. In the sea of opinions, InFocus photographers have answered the call. What does change mean to them? I believe our voices are meaningful and memorable. I believe what we're doing here today with this exhibit and through tonight's conversations is and will make a future that has a different kind of flavor than what we have today. So turning back to the curator, Elizabeth Sussman, she created an exhibition she believed in, the 1993 biennial, and it failed. However, 20 years after, perspectives changed, the world changed, and that biennial has become a benchmark of important cultural conversation that is still ongoing today. Our voices matter. These photographs matter. What we do today might seem like a drop of water in the ocean, but time will tell. We cannot control how others see our art or how this exhibition will be judged. To quote someone very wise, all we have to do is decide what to do with the time given us. Does anybody know who said that? Gandalf, Lord of the Rings. So I just want to say thank you so much for being here. Thank you for lending your voices and being a part of this community.